My world that I want to have a little pride in. My world, and it's not a place I have to hide in. Life's not worth a damn till you can say I am what I am.
Co-directors of this campaign. The truth is, as we said from the very beginning, you are the campaign. And so just to say that, as with all these 70 Yes Equality groups around the country, and some of you are here today, the fact is that every single conversation that has been had, every single hour that you've spent talking to people, there is no doubt that we've had a national conversation, and that conversation will continue. And I think what we will see happening over the coming months and years is that all of us who today, for the first time, experience full equality in this country, that we continue, we will continue to be proud to be Irish, because today I think the generosity and the love of all of the Irish citizens has been extended to each and every one of us, and I want to say thank you sincerely.
To add to that, if Irish people have, and I'm a cautious person from time to time, but I'm waiting until 6 o'clock, but if they have said what I think they've said it in a way that is beyond what we dreamt, beyond what I think most of us in this room dreamt. Most of us thought we would have to clutch at our equality, and what turns out, I think, is that it's been handed to us with love, with affection, with generosity. The reason that happened is because all of us in this room and tens of thousands of other people all around the country said and asked people, can we belong in Ireland? And they said yes. And I think there's something quite extraordinary about Ireland that we've just pulled out from years of austerity, from years of gloom. We've pulled it out somewhere or other. And you can see that, I think, mostly in the home to vote, where people, I'm sure there are hope. There are some of you here in this room, are you? Who?
I've just had so many conversations with people here in this room this morning who I've known for the last 30 years in terms of the building the foundations of what has happened today. And I am so proud. I am so happy. It was a fantastic campaign. You are all, I was sitting at home behind the computer, oh, I wish I was home canvassing. I wish I could be out canvassing. I did it online. I did whatever I could. But look, it was fantastic. I have never, ever, ever been so proud to be part of this wonderful, wonderful community. It's just,
here's Kate, who came back from Mozambique.
So, I wasn't expecting to have to make a speech or anything, but it has been an incredible privilege to be able to be home for this referendum. I think we have to consider all of the people who asked us to be their yeses as well, and who weren't able to take either the time off work or afford the ticket home. I think we're representing a lot more than is maybe present today. In particular, I guess I want to make a shout out to some other family members who are gay and who had to leave Ireland or felt they had to leave Ireland because they were gay, and have been in touch with me over the course of the day to say that they're essentially in floods of tears, much like the rest of us, but in floods of tears and delighted to be able to now proudly say that they are Irish and to be the first in the world to make that statement and to stand up together with their straight brothers and sisters and say that we are a nation for equality. I think there'll be a lot of people thinking of Ireland over the next days, and I can say from Mozambique anyway, there are a lot of people who are very thankful to have Ireland stand up for them and hopefully continue to do so in the international arena as well. So thank you all.
And on behalf of Bráinne, can I just say one thing actually. We started out 88 days ago, staff from Glen, from Marriage Equality, from the ICCL in an office, and it was kind of a lonely office because there was a lot of desks and a few chairs and not much else. We didn't know if we'd find the money, we didn't know if we'd find the people, we didn't know if we could establish a network. We hoped we could, we believed we could, but we didn't know it. And we were joined in head office by a most extraordinary group of very talented, very creative, very courageous, and very hardworking individuals. I know many of you are here.
Here, yes. Here.
Later on, I hope, but just they echoed the spirit that I think we invoked in Ireland. That idea where people turned up at 8 o'clock in the morning and left again at midnight in a spirit of contribution, voluntary, unpaid, and serious about the kind of Ireland they wanted to create. And that's been mirrored all across Ireland. So I don't know where all this energy and creativity goes, but I think over time, we need to think about that. How do we ensure that we have full, true, lived equality for lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender people? But that's next week's work. So enjoy until 6 o'clock. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. small independent republic to the entire world is one of dignity and freedom and tolerance, liberté, fraternité, égalité. Thank you.
Total poll 1,949,725. Invalid ballot papers 13,818. Total valid poll 1,935,907. Votes in favour of the proposal 1,201,600. Majority of votes in favour of the proposal 467,307. Shortly online on referendum.ie. Gonna get up, gonna get up, gonna get up. Oh.